Hi everyone, let's see how to select a chillBooster system in CPQ. After logging in, you select New Project and you enter the project name, in this case chillBooster test. You select an organization, CAREL Italy for this particular case, and you select a customer. In this case, go with the default customer. Next, you select the application relating to the current project, the project you are working on. Note that evaporative cooling no longer needs to be selected for selecting the chillBooster system. This means that you can select the exact application you are working on. For example, here we can select, let's say, commercial and a hotel, for example. Then you go save. Then you can go to system outline tab, where you can rename, add and delete the system and the zones. For this case, system one becomes main building, and zone one becomes gas cooler A. Okay. Then you go in the design tab, where you select the system you are working on. In this case, just one is main building. Then you select the designed unit of measure for temperature, that may be Celsius or Fahrenheit, and for the length, so maybe metric or imperial. And in the configuration menu, you have to know that to activate the chillBooster selection, you choose condensers gas cooler. So in this way, the humidification process will be set automatically to adiabatic. Now you enter the data based on the project. So for example, you can have let's say 55,000, altitude 0, so sea level. Temperature upstream of distributor, let's say 35 degrees Celsius. Humidity upstream of distributor, let's say 45. And humidity downstream of distributor, let's say 90%. So you calculate, and you can see here the thermodynamic process and the evaluated humidification load. In this case is 251.2 kg per hour. Then you go and select the atomizer, evaporative cooling, the chillBooster, and you get multiple sections. In this, if necessary, you can override the humidification load. In this case, you can, for example, set to 250. Then you go in the humidity production section, and you select the pump material. So it's gonna be brass or stainless steel. In this case, we are selecting brass. The power supply and certification, and you choose based on availability at the installation site and the required specification for your project. So you go, for example, in this case, this one. UV disinfection and sanitizer inside the cabinet. For reason of hygiene, the customer may be requesting the installation of an UV lamp to destroy any bacteria that may be present in the water that's sprayed. So let's say yes or no, depending on the request on the customer. In this case, maybe yes. And the inlet water filter kit, vessel plus cartridge. This is recommended to prevent debris and impurities from entering the cabinet water circuit. So let's say in this case, select yes. Going on in the coil type selection, you can select the layout of the condenser gas cooler that you are working on. So the CPQ will choose the right distribution system based on this selection. Now for this example, we select V-shaped dry cooler. Moving on, humidity distribution for gas cooler A. The manifold position here, select where the manifold will be placed on the dry cooler used for this project. This depends on a possible installation constraint and any impediments that there may be around the coil. You can see the help text here. Sorry, here. For more information. For example, you may be having a problem installing the system on both sides of the coil, so you can select just one side. Please note that the letters here, A and B, refers to the letters you find in the picture here above. So A and B. If you select just one side, it's gonna be just A or B, of course. So one side. For this project, we select two sides, A plus B. Then you insert the width, the height, and the depth of the coil. So here again, the letters correspond to those indicated in the drawing above. X, Y, and Z. X here, Y, and Z. So for this project, let's say here, here, and here. Nozzle type, then. You select the size of a nozzle based on the load. So we have the 5 liters per hour, 7.5 liters per hour, and 15 liters per hour. The default is red, and that's the value you should start with. Distribution configuration, it's depending on the project, the desired solution could be the one that offers the best feeling of the coil, and therefore the highest cooling performances. Or the simplest system, and therefore the one with the fewest component. So the selection will be different if you select one of or the other. The default value is best nozzle distribution, best absorption distances. Connector material, you can again select between brass and stainless steel. Now we go with brass. Drain valve, again, with the material, is gonna be brass or stainless steel. Brass, again, for this case. Here, you select the drain valve outdoor enclosure. Is gonna be selected to add more protection to the valve, that, of course, is gonna be installed outside. So, for this case, we select yes. And corrugated hose from cabinet to coil. You select the distance between the cabinet and the coil. In this example, let's say we have the distance between, that's 10 meters, but here you see we have multiple solution, that can be also none. The WTS selection, using the mineralized water has the advantage of preventing the formation of slime scale on the coil. However, it's also important to underline that this type of water can be aggressive to the fins. So always remember to check compatibility with the customer if you want to go with the mineralized water. So that's why the default value is no. And we stay with no. But if you want, you can size the WTS for one system or for more than one system if you have. Accessories, UV lamp replacement, of course, the customer may be requesting an accessory to replace when the old one break. The water filter replacement, again, it may be yes or no depending on the customer request. So you go with suggest solution. Here you see that the algorithm provides the list of part number needed for the project. First part, the humidity production area, is selected the correct pump depending on the load and the request on the power supply and certification. And of course here, since we selected the yes on the UV sanitizer, it's gonna be with the UV sanitizer. Again, if you selected so, you get the inlet water filter. In the humidity distribution section, you have a schematic diagram of how of the coil with the manifold installed. So here you see it's gonna be the two sides that we selected, side A and side B, with the width and the height you selected, and the representation, schematic representation, of the manifold on the coil. Moving on, here you have all the component and the complete list of the part number and quantities needed, with a key, with the legenda, referring to the diagram above. So, for example, you have T brass, that's with this symbol. You can find it easily on the scheme, and that's like that for every single part present here in the scheme. Accessories, those are automatically selected based on the previous selection. So you can have a UV lamp and a water filter if you selected yes above. Then the services you may add to the quote, and last part, the accessories. Here is a manual selection, so if you think that you need more of this component, you just add here the quantity. Be aware that everything that's needed for the standard installation is already present. You don't have to add anything, but you may be willing to add more caps for any particular reason. So you just go here and select 1, 2, or whatever. So you go on and save. Then you can go on to the quote tab. You see there's gonna be all the components you selected. And here you can download the quote to share with the customer. So it's gonna be PDF or Excel file. Let's check the first option, the PDF. Here you have the quote for your project in PDF format with the name, the customer name, and the date. After the table of contents, you have a summary here of all the parts numbers needed for the project, divided into accessories, services, humidity production, and humidity distribution. After some additional notes, there's the last part of the code recap with the accessories and services. Below, there's a diagram of the chillBooster system, the chillBooster cabinet here, alongside the type of unit selected. In this case, the V-shaped system. Of course, if you selected the W-shaped, here you'll have a W-shaped system. Continuing on, there's a scheme of the distribution system, already seen when selecting the components. Here, you see there are some numbers that will be used on-site by the installer as a reference to see what code this picture refers to. Below this scheme, there's a table that recaps all the number of nozzles, in this case 50, number of caps, 26, and the how many manifolds are on each side. So divided by the code, you have 2 on side A, 2 on side B, and 0 of the other in this particular case. And of course, how many lines, 2, as you can see by the scheme. Below, there's a table showing all the part numbers from the cabinet to the WTF is present, and all the distribution system. This table will contain both a graphic key and numerical references. We can be found in a diagram on the previous page, the one we just saw. Further below, there's some technical information on the product, and finally, later, you have the psychometric diagram for the process with information of the load and all the thermodynamic conditions.